Hello friends, myself Professor Anand Kudoli. Today I am going to explain you forces acting on the gravity dam. Okay, so these are the forces acting on the gravity or concrete dam. So number one is water pressure force, uplift pressure force, wave pressure force, silt pressure force, ice pressure force, and a weight of the dam. So first one is water pressure force. In that, the water which is stored in the reservoir, which is exerting the pressure force on the upstream face of the dam. Okay, and it is generally calculated by hydrostatic law. In that, the pressure intensity goes on increasing with increasing in the depth. Means at the surface level, the intensity of pressure is very low, means zero, and at the bottom, the intensity of pressure is very high. And generally it is calculated by calculating the area of this triangle, and that is equal to one half base into height, and that is gamma w into h square divided by 2, and which is acting from the base h by 3. Okay, and from top it acts as 2 by 3 h. Okay, and gamma w is equal to specific weight, and that is equal to weight upon volume. Okay, and this case is when upstream face is straight, but whenever it is inclined like this, then vertical component of water pressure is also coming into the picture. But when the face is straight, that time only horizontal component of water pressure is incoming into the picture. But whenever this is in incline, that time vertical water pressure is also coming into picture. So it is equal to a weight of water stored in the ABCD column, and it acts through its cg of that area. Okay, and that is equal to area of ABCD into gamma w, and that is coming in the unit kilonewton per meter, because we are here considering only two dimensions, that is width of the dam and height of the dam. Okay, we are not considering the length of the dam. So here we are considering assuming unit length, that is 1 meter. So if we consider the unit length, that is 1 meter, then the force will come into the kilonewton, because force is always expressed in kilonewton. Force or weight is always expressed in kilonewton. Okay. Then if the water which is exist in the tails, means downstream side, means tail water is also existing, then the same calculations are done, but only in the opposite direction, means horizontal component will act in opposite direction and vertical component is act in the downward direction, that I have given here, you can see here. Then next one is uplift pressure. Uplift pressure is that water pressure which is actually water is seeped through the upstream side through the foundation, through pores, fissures or cracks, and even through the body of the dam also. Then all the water is collected at the base of the dam, and which creates the pressure, and that is from downward to upward side. Okay, and that pressure is called uplift pressure, and its calculation is also a matter of research, but currently suggested by US United States of Bureau Reclamation, that the hydrostatic pressure available at the heel and the hydrostatic pressure intensity available at the toe marked there, and then by drawing this straight line, we draw the pressure distribution diagram as you can see here. Okay, and by calculation the calculating the area of this pressure distribution diagram, we can calculate the uplift pressure force, and that is equal to K into gamma w into b into h plus h dash. H dash is the height of water in the upstream downstream side, and h is the height of the water towards the upstream side. Okay, then by that formula we can calculate the uplift pressure force, and where K is equal to permeability constant, which is zero for good rock foundation, and this is depends upon the permeability of foundation, and it acts upwards of the foundation. Generally, uplift pressure reduces the self weight of the dam. So as far as possible, we have to take care that foundation should be impermeable so that minimum uplift pressure can be applied there. Okay, then next one is seismic force. Whenever the area where we are going to construct the dam, then a dam, that is, if it is coming in the seismic zone, then we have to consider the earthquake forces or seismic forces, because whenever earthquake is occurs, that time dam should not be failed due to earthquake forces. Okay, so we have to take care of that forces also while designing the dam. Earthquake forces are generates the waves, and those waves are capable to shake the earth on which dam is rest. Okay, so waves will move in any direction, and it gives acceleration to the foundation. So acceleration is also in any direction for a design purpose, we take only vertical acceleration and horizontal acceleration, that is alpha v and alpha h. Generally, the values expressed in the percentage of acceleration due to gravity, that is alpha is equal to 0.1 g and or 0.2 g. G is nothing but acceleration due to gravity. Okay, and then if we calculate the vertical acceleration, then if that vertical acceleration is acting towards the upward direction, in that case foundation tries to closer to the foundation, and hence it will increase the effective weight of the dam, and it goes to it becomes W in bracket 1 plus alpha V bracket complete. Okay, and when the vertical acceleration is acting towards direction towards downward direction, in that case foundation tries to goes away from the dam, and that's why it reduces the effective weight of dam, and that is equal to W in bracket 1 minus alpha V. Next one is silt pressure. In the silt pressure, silt is deposited at the upstream face of the dam, and which is acting same like water pressure, that is horizontal as well as vertical component. Okay, and that is given by rho gamma s into h square divided by 2 and in bracket 1 minus sine phi divided by 1 plus sine phi, that is given by Rankine's theory. Okay, and gamma s is equal to specific weight of silt, and h is equal to depth of silt deposited in meter, and phi is the angle of internal friction of silt, and this is normally a minor pressure force. Then other forces are in that ice pressure, when reservoir is likely to freeze, ice pressure should be considered. Normally ice pressure is also a minor pressure, because whenever in any country, if the temperature goes below 0 degree, means it is likely to become a chances of water to become ice, and in that case only ice pressures are taken into account. And next one is wind pressure. It is also one of the minor force which acts on the exposed faces of dam, and generally it is given by Pw is equal to 2.4 into gamma w into Hw, where Hw is equal to height of water from top crest. Okay, and last one is weight of the dam. Generally, specialty of gravity dam is to resist the all the forces acting on the dam are resisted by the self weight of the dam, and generally we are considering here only two dimensions only, means width and height of the dam. And if we consider the third dimension also, then it becomes volume, and weight of the dam is calculated by weight of the dam is calculated by volume into specific weight of the materials, specific weight of the material, so that we can calculate the self weight of the dam. Okay, so these were the forces acting on the dam. Thank you very much for watching this video. Okay, see you.